Hello everyone, welcome to Ortho Implants for Life. This week, we will learn about dynamic
condyler
screws fixation procedure. So, let's begin.
So, let us discuss about the procedure of fixing a dynamic condyler screw plate and all the implants and instruments used for it. First, we will take the angle guide and fix the QC handle attachment to it. Once done, we will insert the 2.5 mm guide wire through this hole into the fracture site, and then we remove the angle guide and the guide wire stays back. Next, we take the measurement of the guide wire using a measuring scale. We measure the length of the guide wire inserted in the femoral neck. Once the measurement is done, we will take a triple action reamer and set the reamer in the exact length that we have measured using the measuring scale. As you can see here, a demarcation of the length. Once done, then we lock it and then use it to ream through. This part will touch the cortex of the bone. We will rim till this part touches the outer cortex of the bone. Then we take the reamer out. Then we use a DCS DHS tap with the short centering sleeve attached to it. Then attach the QC handle at the end of this tap, and then use it to tap. Once the tapping is done, we will take a T-handle with guide shaft and a lag screw. First, we attach the long centering sleeve in the T-handle, and then connect the screw with the T-handle. Once the lag screw is attached, we insert the lag screw through the guide wire and then remove the T-handle. The lag screw stays inside. After this, we remove the guide wire as well, and then we connect the coupling screw or the plate holder with the lag screw. We tighten it. After this, we take the DCS plate and then fix it. As you can see, the coupling screw will pass through this hole. After this, we remove the coupling screw. After this, we connect the top screw or the compression screw in this end of the lag screw with the help of a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver. Once completely locked, we check if the plate is not aligned. We will use the impactor and hammer it gently until it is properly placed on the bone. Thereafter, we use a 3.2 mm drill bit. Then we take the measurement with the help of the depth gauge. Then we use the 4.5 mm tap to tap through the hole. Then we take a 4.5 mm cortical screw of the measured length, and with the help of a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver, we fix the screw in the shaft region of the DCS plate. Now let us understand about these two holes. These two holes are for 6.5 mm cancellous screw. Cortical screw are not fixed here. And for that, we use a 4.3 mm drill bit measure the length with the help of a depth gauge and take a 6.5 mm cannulated cancellous screw of the measured length and again use a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver to fix the cancellous screw. Then we fix as many screws as a surgeon wants to and is required. And that's all for the fixation procedure of DCS plate and screw. Now let us understand the removal process of this plate. Firstly, we will use a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver and remove all the screws one by one. Then we remove the top screw or the compression screw. Then we remove the DCS plate. After that, we attach the T-handle and then insert the guide shaft through the T-handle. Lock the lag screw with the guide shaft. And then we remove the lag screw slowly. We use the guide shaft so that the lag screw does not get stuck inside anywhere and it comes out smoothly.
If you have enjoyed the video, like it, share it. If you are new to our channel, subscribe it. Hit the bell icon to get the notifications for our upcoming videos. If you have any queries, comment below and we will surely reply back. If you want to know more about career prospects in orthopedic implant industry and wish to start a career in orthopedic implant industry, please click the link below in the description box and DM us to know more. Thank you and see you in our next video.